seagulls. What can you do? We started down by Town Beach, and we have, if I'm right in saying, we have the largest rainbow flag in the UK. So that was all unraveled down the hill. We were all grabbing bits. So we were on the red side and waited for the parade to start, as you can see by some of the footage that I took. We walked up through town and there was lots of roll the flag, unroll the flag, because it's huge and our streets are not huge. There was a marching band. I don't think I've ever been to a Pride parade that didn't have a marching band, but there was a marching band playing YMCA on repeat, which wasn't bad. Just never seen that done before. And then we arrived onto the killer court where all of the stuff was. It was kind of uneventful in a good way. It was just really, really nice. And it was really nice because you could, it was very much full of younger people. So that brings me on to the subtopic of this video, is what was it like for me growing up gay in Cornwall? And it was a struggle. The only real resources I had were the ones that I could find on Google. Cornwall is not known for its gay scene. It is known for being sunny. It's known for seagulls, it's known for pasties. Obviously it's known for more than that, but it's queer scene, not so much. I didn't really have any gay friends growing up, not until I was about 15, 16, and by that point I'd already come out as bi, kind of testing the waters sort of thing. That's not what bisexual is, by the way. Growing up, always being called gay, even when I wasn't gay. It was like the go-to insult, that and goofy teeth, because I didn't have brilliant teeth. I was beaten up for being gay quite a lot, even when I wasn't gay. Mostly in school as well, it wasn't so bad like on the streets. It was only literally in the school where all that happened. There was all sorts of queer-related name-calling, let's go with. And then obviously the physical, like, taking a beating. And things just like being like pushed into stuff at school and like having stuff knocked out of my hands, you know, usual bullying sort of stuff. But that was all when I thought I was straight. I remember like, okay, cool, so I might be bi, great. And we had, as part of our like PSHE, which is kind of like sex education without talking about any sort of sex and relationship stuff, we had one session where a counsellor kind of came in and she was like, yeah, I'm gay, and then spoke to us about gay stuff. And that was the only time anyone had ever like taught us about it or spoken about it. And then she came in and gave the session and everyone was like, okay, cool, maybe we should stop beating people up for being gay. Didn't happen. But I went to my head of year and I was like, hey, I think I could benefit from some of the sessions she offered. Could you put us in touch? And that didn't happen. I was just kind of like left on my own to kind of deal with that, which was fine. And then, what did I do? I don't know what I did. Google, mostly. Yeah, Google sex education. No, I wouldn't recommend. But yeah, so I was bi for a bit and then I was like, nope, I'm not bi, I'm full on gay. And then came out as gay, wrote I'm gay on my face. It wasn't brilliant, everyone just thought I was kidding. But then everybody wanted to be my friend as soon as I came out. Well, as soon as I came out as a lesbian, let's go with that. And then I did more like Google research into like, what even is gender anyway? And then around the same time I met my ex, who is a trans woman. That was kind of when I was like, okay, so I should probably look up trans issues, because not one session in school has ever taught us about that. So I took to Google. Thank you, Google. Not sponsored. When you come out of something that's not the L, the G, the B, or the T, you spend the rest of your life explaining what it is to people. So I was doing a lot of that in Cornwall. So I am talking. So in, whenever it was, when was it? 17, 18, so I was in the sixth form, college-ish. I was the first person in my school that I know of to have ever come out as non-binary. And I spent the entire year teaching my teachers what it meant. and answering all of the questions, all of the invasive questions. So growing up gay in Cornwall is basically having a close relationship with Google and people's fists and the floor. But now, like, when, so yesterday's Pride, there were so many young people there. So I was hanging out with my sister and, well, I took my sister to Pride, and then when we were there, she saw all her friends. So I was kind of basically hanging out with a group of like 13 to 15 year olds. And they were all just so nice. Like, when I was younger, the 13, 15 year olds were savage, and being gay wasn't okay. But then, like, hanging out with these young people, and they're all just like, so what pronouns do you use? And calling me a sibling instead of a sister, and I'm just like, my gay little heart is so happy. So things have obviously changed, and very much proud of the youth generation, says me at 23, still young. Growing up in Cornwall used to be really hard and a challenge. Now it doesn't seem to be so hard, and that's in part down to Cornwall Pride and all of the resources that they sequester over time and give to schools, and just people becoming more familiar with queer stuff and queer people, having more queer people in the media that's like global, and more of it, more like queer activism online, more videos online, so like on YouTube and stuff, and just more access to queer stuff so you can get acquainted with it and you can ask the questions about yourself and you can discover stuff rather than just being like, what does being trans mean, Google? That's growing up queer in Cornwall from 10 years ago compared to now, I guess. I guess I'll have to do. Don't forget to like this video. If you have any comments, drop them down below, and make sure you are subscribed to my channel. Ring the notification bell down below so you get notified every single time I post a video. Videos go up every Saturday at 6 p.m. with at least one bonus video every single month. See ya!